How's it going, my friends? Welcome back to Sully's Models, and in this episode we're basically looking at finishing the car. Now, this is not the end of the series. We've still got one more to do, which is going to be the vignette for the whole thing. So, but in this video we're going to be looking at a couple of small little details to go onto the car. So we're still looking at needing to do like the bumpers and the rear view mirrors. We're also looking at even some more weathering on it today. We're going to be looking at basically moss. Really one of my favourite bits of nature. I've got a thing for moss. I think it's brilliant. just grows everywhere in some really weird fashions. But it's also a really cool thing to sort of make these models look a little bit more realistic. Now, particularly as this one, it's going to be sat underneath a tree as well, so you are going to get that sort of moss build up underneath it. So we're going to be looking at that. We're going to be looking at how we've done the moss and some sort of like, you know, kind of like moss streaking, if you like. Not really sure how to explain it very well, but we'll get into the video and you can see what I mean. Right, let's start with the bumper. Now, one of the great things about these kits is that you get these nice, you know, chrome looking you know, bits and pieces. But as soon as you cut them off the sprue, you can see the plastic underneath. Now, the bane of my life, these sort of things, and you know, no matter what you do, trying to clean it up and everything, and of course, you're just gonna get more and more plastic coming through and taking off that really nice high finish. So, really the only thing to do is scrub it all off and start again. Now, unfortunately, I haven't anything that will give us this nice high gloss chrome finish, but to be fair, we don't really need it, because what we're doing, obviously, we're making this car look like it's a bag of nails, and we don't really need it to be this nice and high gloss finish. So let's have a little bit of a look of what I've got in the paint store, and you know, see what I can get to sort of match the color. Now, the closest I had was either MIG's steel or AK's chrome finish. Every time I've tried it, doesn't quite come out as nice and fancy as that, so we'll have to have a little bit of a look, clear this all up, and we'll see what we can come up with. So afterwards, I decided we're going to go for the AK Extreme Metals. It's going to produce probably the better finish. To do that, we need to base all our parts with the highest gloss possible if you want to get a really, really nice shine out of this stuff. Now, I will say, if you want to thin it down or clean it, you need to use their own thinners. And to be fair, it works on its own. But one of the things I really like with it is it just moves on its own. I could spend ages just looking at it. It's amazing. Anyway, so we've painted the part. You can pretty much flood the stuff and it doesn't really do anything, because this stuff self-levels. Anyway, so before we get into making that look a bit rougher, I'll go through some of the other details. So for the when the ring mirrors, decided to have it a little bit busted, so I drilled a nice small hole, drilled a little bit of wire into the other rear view mirror and pushed it through, bent the excess over, and super glued it into place. You know, pretty much nice and easy, nice, quite simple sort of detail to do. And I probably also admit it's probably one of my favourite sort of little details that I've done. So moving on to sort of like the front lighting area, back it, I don't know what you're going to call, I don't know what to call it, the fascias. So they're painted in matte black. I used MIG's one shot primer. Didn't feel like I had to worry about actually really painting it and anything else. Gave it a light dry brushing with a little bit of white, and use MIG steel to sort of do all the fancy trims on there, which I think gives a nice, you know, really nice finish on there, and probably looks closest to the, you know, the real thing. So moving on to the lights themselves, didn't really have to do too much because it's only the rear ones I actually had to paint, so I used Tamiya's clear red. I backed them with silver, which gives that reflector underneath and gives it a good finish. To stick them in, glue and glaze. It's like a white glue, it's a bit like PVA. Just put a load on. Stuff dries ultra clear, so you haven't really got to worry about any, you know, catching it on any of your clear parts. If you do, just a little bit of water and it clears it out. There you go, looks really nice. So, back to the bumper. If you remember in the previous episode of the rusting technique I did, if you haven't seen the episode, the link will be in the description down below, but basically did exactly the same thing as I did there. And then just to fix it, dab a super glue and fit it into place. Now for the front windscreen, I wanted to smash a plank through the window. So the easiest way of doing that is I put the dashboard roughly into place and kind of lined up the plank from where I wanted it. Sort of measure the gap fairly roughly with obviously piece of plank I'm using, which is a wood stirrer. Marked it out onto the glass, as you can see, with just a, you know, scalpel with a rough thickness, and then with a rotary tool very carefully drilled out a hole at either end of where that plank is supposed to go. I've backed it with a bit of blue tack to reduce any pressure when I'm pushing down the drill bit to drill those holes out. Afterwards, I sort of widened it a little bit and squared off the edges with a flat file and just kept on double checking that would fit. Now, to make it look a little bit more realistic, like it's actually been smashed, all you need to do is use your scalpel, either the back end of the scalpel or the sharp end, whichever you like, and just score some lines in it. You know, get some reference photos off the interweb, you know, and give you some ideas, but basically you just spiderweb it. You know, just get loads of you know, outgoing cracks, and then afterwards just, you know, join them all up with, you know, squiggles and scratches all over the place. Just keep it, you know, ununiformed as possible. So then that's quite nicely fitted into place and ready for some more weathering. But before we go into that, I'll just quickly show you painting the wood itself. I based it in a very dark brown and then mixed a little bit of sort of a grey colour in there to give it that sort of aged effect, and then also added a little bit of a pin wash in there, you know, to make it look a bit older. Now what I'm going to do now is add some moss, because the cart is going to be sat under a tree. You know, you generally get a lot of moss build up because, you know, nature. So all I did was mixed a relatively light green. I think it was called light green by Vallejo. Mixed a little bit of Vallejo black in there just to darken it slightly. And with a sponge, again, exactly the same as the rust patterning as we did in the previous video. Take out most of the excess on a bit of kitchen towel or whatever, so you've just got a nice, just enough of paint on the sponge, and again go to town on the model and just dab away and add some green. It's going to be our moss. So I also wanted a little bit of a streaking effect, so very, very carefully with some thinners on the brush, and just did some downward streaking motion just to get quite literally just some streaking. It's just really simple, as you can see there. Now, even after doing all this, I'm still not sure which way around I should have done this, but this is the way I ended up doing it, is I put a wash over everything. Now, I am happy with the way it turned out, but I'm kind of thinking at the same time, maybe I should put this down first. I don't know. Either way, it turned out fine. But what I used was Flory's Dark Dirt, plastered the entire model in the stuff, and let it dry. Now, this stuff's clay-based. It's great stuff to use. I've used it a lot of times on my aircraft. It's great inside sort of recesses and panel lines to give you that dirty, grimy effect. Now, again, I did exactly the same as I did with the moss, but because this is water-based, just a little bit of water on the brush and just did some downward streaking to give us those streaks. Now, for the moss itself, I went back to the same colors as I did when I dabbed it on, added a bit of PVA glue into the mix, and I added some flocking. I used Woodland Scenics fine turf. Doesn't really matter so much what color you're gonna use, because of course it's gonna be mixed in paint, so doesn't really matter, but it gives you this nice sort of gloppy, gloopy mess. Now, because you've got the PVA glue in there, as well as the paint, it'll help it adhere to the model. And quite simply, all you need to do is just put it into place. And because it's quite, obviously it's quite wet, you know, you can quite easily tease this apart and make some nice sort of thin layers to sit, as you can see, in the top of the window frame there. Because you know, you don't want massive pieces there. So it's quite nice, easy to just tear that up and, you know, place it nicely. It also makes it very easy to put into them nice little nuts and crannies like we did around the headlights. So there we go, guys, that's the car finished. Like I said at the start of the video, the next episode is going to be the last episode, which will be the whole vignette and putting that all together. So there's going to be quite a few bits and pieces in that. We're going to be looking at obviously the base itself, making the tree, and you know, a couple of other little details, so stay tuned for that. So I hope you've enjoyed the video. I hope it's helped you a little bit. Hope this series helps a little bit, because it's part of the reason why I did this series, to help you get some idea of doing some weathering and some other techniques. You know, I mean, I know I've done this on a car, but it's quite easy to sort of transition some of this stuff onto other models, particularly like tanks, you know, even derelict aircraft, you know, stuff that's been abandoned. You can do some very similar stuff using the techniques that I've done in this series. So yeah. So again, I hope you've enjoyed it. If you haven't done so already, please like and subscribe to the channel. If you guys would like to and help support the channel, there's a link in the description below. But otherwise, again, last time, thanks very much for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one.